Hello guys, it's Chef Blake, and like we promised, we are delivering your juicy Jamaican stew oxtail with broad beans and fried plantains. You won't want to miss this.
Welcome back to Blakewrtv Kitchen. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Chef Blake.
Good morning, guys. How y'all doing out there? Hope everybody's doing good. Feeling great. We're on the show, and today, guys, we are bringing to you your oxtail. I know you guys been waiting, and we've been promising. Today, we are bringing to you guys your oxtail, your stew oxtail with broad beans. Here, we got some oxtail over here.
We've got a lot of oxtail over here that we're about to prepare for you guys.
And with our oxtail, we are going to make some fried plantain. We're gonna make some fried plantains, and we have some butter bean here. We have some butter beans, and we're gonna use some coconut milk to make some rice and peas with fried plantain, broad bean, with our oxtail. So it's gonna be a nice, delicious dinner today. So check it out. Hang with us in the kitchen. You know, Chef Blake, something always sizzling. Okay, guys, so it's time for us to do what?
It's time for us to prep our meat, wash our meat.
Yep.
So we're transferring it into this bowl here.
Just like that. Okay, let's drain them off. Okay, guys, so if you want to take a scissors.
Kitchen scissors.
Make sure you use a kitchen scissors and just cut off any little fat. That is too much. You don't want to cut off all the fat. You want to leave a little fat on it, but just cut off as much as you consider to be excess on it. Okay, let's go.
No, let me.
Putting on some garlic powder here.
That looking good now. Now it smells nice.
Are you going to have some of this, I'm putting on some ginger here.
Mm-hmm. You know, that's our ginger, guys.
You know, ginger give it a good flavor, right?
Yep.
So there we go. I'm going to cut up a little bit of real ginger on it. I'm going to put a little bit of powder right now.
About me?
But I'm going to put in some real ginger. Mario, what's going on, youth? Everything good? Bless up yourself. Up the mic. You
know.
You.
Aiden.
Okay, we got some turmeric here. So put some turmeric here. And why do we use turmeric?
Because it's good. Because
it has a lot of health benefits. It's versatile. You could use it in anything.
Look good already, right?
Yeah.
Okay. That looks like good.
I like to use Little Miss.
Miss is it Dash? Is that Mr. or Mrs.?
Hold on. Do they have Mr. and Mrs. Dash?
Just look like it's a regular Dash.
Okay, this one is table blend. And this one is original. So, I'm going to use a little bit of table. Should I use both of them?
Could use both.
Yeah. As long as I get
use
that,
both sparingly.
Put a little bit of Mrs. Dash, and then I put a little bit of the original. All right, so there we go. Oh, the original has some kind of seed to it.
Welcome back.
Like you have sea salt and stuff in it. So yeah, that's
welcome
the difference.
Back,
a little bit of complete season right here. And you can pick, you can call up the season for me.
Okay.
Let people know what you're doing.
Let's mix up our seasoning.
Hey, Aiden, what are you putting two in there, boy? You want to be in every little thing I'm doing. Okay.
Dice so this, ginger.
So we put some ginger. And we're going to put this ginger in what?
Hand.
We're going to put this ginger in what, Alexi? You know what?
You pressurize it. Isn't that...
This ginger is going to go in our oxtail. A part of the mix.
And the part of me.
Yeah.
You can do it. So here we have some ginger. So we'll go ahead and add the ginger in it in the mixture. Add the ginger right here to our pot. You smell that aroma from the ginger?
Yeah.
That'll give it a nice flavor. Trust me. Alright, the next thing on the menu is our red onion. So let's get this red onion prepped. Why do we use red onion all the time? You know the reason? Tell me the reason.
More
last time I was with Quincy. What Quincy cooked the last time? Quincy cooked some
Quincy cooked some red pea soup the last time, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that was good.
And yeah.
So Quincy was the one who introduced me to this red onion. Because I usually just use the white onion. But Quincy told me, Sabuai, the red onion have a better flavor. Let me check it out. And it is. The red onion have a better flavor than the white onion. Cost a little bit more in the store. Okay, we have an onion here. Let's go ahead and dice it up. You want to stick the stew down and everything. Give it some nice flavor. Careful when cutting on the board.
We are now adding in our purple onions. Is it red onions? Purple onions? Yep. We're adding our onions into our oxtail. We're gonna mince our scallion up.
What type of flavor scallion gives to your food?
Similar to like the onion.
They give it a flavor.
But not as strong, I think.
A remarkable flavor.
Add in our scallion. Here's our pure ground black pepper. And we're gonna just
put a little bit. We're just eyeball it. We haven't been doing much measuring. We're just gonna do a little eyeball of this thing over here. Put a little black pepper to give it a little kick. There we go.
I'm gonna mix well.
Yeah, get that thing all mixed because you need to make sure your season get into your
meat.
Into your meat. Get the best taste. Mm-hmm.
So we're adding in some Maggi.
Polo.
Pollo.
Pollo. Put a little bit on it to give it a flavor. It does give it a flavor to it. So this is good. You go ahead and store that in for me. Get that oxtail really nice. Okay. There we go.
Half a spoonful of browning, grace browning.
And this just give it a nice color.
Color, yes.
That's all it done. Let's give it a color.
Get your hands in there and mix that up.
You want to get all the
spread
season.
Spread the color and the seasoning.
I'm going to get that seasoning here real good.
Some Spanish thyme leaves here.
Okay, guys, we have some Spanish thyme. We'll go ahead and cut it up.
I'm going to add in our Spanish thyme leaves that we just minced up to our oxtail with some extra flavor. I'm about to put our pot on the fire for our caramelized sugar. I'm going to add in a large spoonful.
Yep.
Yep.
We're gonna make that turn into some molasses.
Yep. Here's our brown sugar that we let melt over the fire.
Caramelize this sugar to give it that nice flavor.
A good base for our oxtails. Now we are transferring our oxtails into our pressure cooking pot. About a tablespoon, half a tablespoon.
It's less than a quarter.
Maybe like 2 teaspoons.
Yeah. We're gonna add a little bit of water to it. Make sure it doesn't
dry out
too fast.
It's
gonna be in the pressure cooker for about 45 minutes.
But you don't wanna add too much water and, you know, ruin the flavor.
Yeah, so that's another idea too. So you gotta check it. Check it in about 20 minutes.
Just add water as needed.
See it going. You want to taste it?
Not yet.
Taste it? Tastes good.
Pot into our pressure cooker. Now, we're going to set it. Setting it to 45 minutes on our electric pressure cooker.
Just now
I'm going to start it. And make sure it's turn to the lock and we'll be back.
Okay, guys, it has been a good for 45 minutes.
Yeah.
This thing been going on for a while, so we're gonna check it. Let's go over here. You gotta be careful with this thing because you have a lot of pressure.
It's locked, so apply it to the
You know, I never like open pressure cooker. That's what I always don't like.
Okay guys, here we have our oxtail in our frying pan. And we're just gonna let this sit for a while. Gather those juices a little more. And here we still have our kidney beans boiling over the fire.
Yes guys, as you can see, our stew oxtail coming on nicely right now. It's full of flavor. The whole kitchen is just popping with flavor right now. Irresistible flavor. It's gonna be tasty, gonna be delicious. Trust me, you and your belly do not want to miss this.
And in our Caribbean rhythm butter beans to our oxtails. Oxtails is renowned for having butter beans. It's tradition.
Okay guys, here we are with some plantains. We are frying some plantain, guys. So a fried plantain to go with our oxtail. Over here we have some, y'all know what these are already. Some broccoli steaming down. And here's our rice pot. I'm gonna burn myself. Here's the rice steaming down too. Look at that Jamaican coconut milk rice, guys. Tell me if that don't look good. Smells good. And last but not least, here we are. That's the oxtail, guys. That good old Jamaican oxtail. Authentic recipe right here. Remember, you get it right here in Blakewrtv Kitchen. Go ahead and subscribe, guys. More good stuff coming up for Thanksgiving as well. So keep it locked right here. Blakewrtv
Kitchen. Here we have our food is ready. We have our rice and beans and our butter bean and oxtail here. Doesn't it look good, Aiden?
Yeah.
Looks great. Can't wait to try it. And we also have our plantains on the side, which is tradition. And if you guys want to see some more food like this, like, comment, and let us know what you guys want to see in next video. Aiden, let us know what they have to do.
Okay. So remember to like, share, and subscribe, and comment, and turn on your notifications for more videos.